So there's a number of deeds that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned within the Sunnah, which if a person were to do, then that person will be granted the rights to Shafa'ah. And there's a number of types of people who die, such as the martyr, such as other people, who if they were to do that and they die in that form, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows them to become interceders on behalf of other people. Of course, the Prophet ﷺ will be the greatest of all in terms of intercession. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to the Prophet ﷺ, Ishfa' tu shafa'ah. Go and make shafa'ah for the people, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept that shafa'ah from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that intercession from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is as such that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved a type of shafa'ah for himself as well. Yes, that's right. We have a hadith in al-Bukhari in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this perhaps is the longest hadith in Bukhari. In this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ explained certain affairs of the Day of Judgment, and he shared with us a number of different things. One of those things is a conversation between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the people of Jannah. So the people of Jannah will come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they will say, our brothers, they used to pray with us, they used to fast with us, they used to do hajj with us. You have entered them into hellfire, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then tell the angels to take them out of hellfire and join them with the brothers of theirs within Jannah, with the friends of theirs and the believers who happen to be brothers in faith with them into Jannah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow these people to speak again, and they will say, our brothers used to pray with us and they used to do such and such with us, and they will decrease one quality, then they will decrease another quality, and then they will finally be coming to as-salah itself. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, and take anyone who has an atom's weight of iman within himself. Okay, so someone who even has a mustard seed of weight of iman within himself and he's in Jahannam, he hasn't even prayed salah, Allah will take those people out and he will enter them into Jannah. This is all from the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They call this shafa'atu rabbil alameen, the intercession of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the human and the jinn kind.